Shalom, children of the Most High God, and may God's peace reign upon your lives, and may He be the ultimate thing. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1 and 2. As for you, you were dead in your transgressions and sins, in which you used to live when you followed the ways of this world, and of the rulers of the kingdom of the air, the spirit who is now at work in those who are disobedient. And then Romans verse 8 and 9. For it is by grace that you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves, it is the gift of God. I want to talk about the initial part of grace over our lives and how the grace part works. Then we can compare it, the subject their grace, to the light. I can make an example of what happened many years ago when I went to my father's homeland, and we drove overnight, and we got there. We couldn't see anything. We could only see as far as the lights can, the car lights can show you. We got onto the place, and then in the midst of all that, we slept. And when we woke up in the morning, I could not believe the beauty of the place. It was an amazing place. But I could not experience that beauty when we got in through the village at night, because of darkness prevented us from seeing the true beauty of the place. The same thing happens with grace. Grace is like the light that shines and shows things for what they truly are. Grace shines its light in two things over your life. The first one is grace shines the light over your sin, the corruption of your sin. Hobola hayona, lemongho wa sebe sa gago. It shines the light onto the filth and the muddy part and how it looks on you. Basically, you start to see yourself as God sees you in the depth of sin. And then the second part, grace shines its light upon the only solution, the only answer to get out of that muddy situation of sin. That's why we call it salvation. You are in the midst of a sin that covers you in every way, the filth and the stench of it, and there is no way, that there's nothing that you can do that can ever save you. And the only thing that can save you and cleanse you from that, those results of sin, is the power of Jesus Christ Himself. So these things are shown in your life, in the times that you have an encounter with God. So it is a privilege in a way that you can meet God, and God can show you your filth, and God can show you how bad you look, and then you can also see a solution that is Christ. Most people can give testimonies to how they came to Christ and say, I was sick and I was healed by the blood of Jesus. They laid hands on me and I received the healing. And the other's testimony could be, my life was a mess financially, and when I started coming to church and they prayed over me and my financial situations came together, and now I am free from debt, and all those are good. He desires that we have life and we have it abundantly. But the main thing of Christ coming for our rescue and dying on the cross was not that we can have a problem-free life here on earth, but the main thing was to, one, cleanse us from our sins. And the only way we can be cleansed from our sins is if we take the deal of being cleansed. And the only way we can take a deal of being cleansed is when we see how rotten we are in sin. Is when we can see the results that sebe go di mogama pelo a bona mongho wa sebe le the effect se sebe se se yetsang wa tsaba ha re bua ka go bola. It's something that is continuously decaying. That's what corruption is over our lives. So we accept the sin. It is by grace that we have been saved through faith, and is not of ourselves. So if we kind of fill the bits to what we have learned today, it is by grace and in brackets, the revelation of who we truly are, how stinky and how rotten we are in the sight of God, with no solution, but continuously being more and more rotten every day. We are corrupt in a corrupt world. And the nature of corruption, again, corruption doesn't stay stagnant. Corruption gets worse and worse. It gets deeper and deeper as the day go by. We cannot reverse ourselves and come out of it. And shown, Hape, the light of Christ. That's the process of grace. It is by grace. It is by the revelation of who we are and the ultimate solution for our sins that we have been saved through faith. And the faith part is accepting the deal that God has and say, now that you see, or you cannot be able to rescue yourself from this mess, I, God, give you the ultimate solution. Grace shines on that and say, Christ is the only solution. Faith is accepting the deal and saying, I, therefore, take the deal of Christ coming to pull me out of the situation, Ekelimoyona, of a dirty and corrupt and rotten state, Sekelim Mosona, to a life together with him. When you read the book of John chapter 3, I think it's verse 17 and 18 or around there. And Lentulamu Dimulere, the sentence is based on this, that the light came into the world. The light came into darkness, but people loved darkness more than the light. Which means grace came and revealed unto you your real state. Grace came and revealed unto you your real position. But our nature loved the sin because of we thought sin at least will sustain us into a good life, aiding, and we rejected the offer of God, salvation through Christ Jesus Christ, because of we thought that we can do it better. Grace itself reveals, and that's the beauty of it. When you read verse 10, let me read. How about verse 10? Kika NIV. For we are God's handiwork, created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared in advance for us to do. For we are God's handiwork, which means when God has redeemed us, or before he redeemed us, verse 10 says, God has a plan for Maphelo Aruna. Sometimes we may not know what God wants for Maphelo Aruna, but when we see ourselves in sin, we accept the deal and we become righteous through Christ. Then we are created afresh. We cannot be doing the things in the way of sin, the way it's like a day. Because firstly, we saw the trueness of ourselves. We cannot, in our good state, go back to what we were, or we didn't love what we were. So we come out of it, and in righteousness, we are a new creation. That it says to me, we literally had to die. That the only way for us to come out of the mess, the corruption of sin, there was no way that we can be cleansed. We literally had to be killed, die, and out of our dead self, a new thing was created, which is now in the righteousness of Christ. And that new thing, God says, this is what I wanted you to do, and this is for a benefit, a thing that I have created you for. Now it speaks purpose. We're not only called for being with God, but we are called for a purpose. The book of John chapter 15 says, I'm the true vine. My father is the gardener. You were born into righteousness. You are like a branch. And every branch that doesn't produce, it is a branch already. It is there. It's a new creation. It is attached to the vine. And he says, you cannot produce anything unless you are in me. We were born for good works. So we don't get born again and it just ends there. We get born again and there is a purpose. Also, I don't really fulfill it. Mapilong Aaron. What is your purpose? You can say, I don't know. Then, Lentula Mudimuleri, you stick with God. Abide in him, and we are always together with him. God starts assigning things over our lives. And the assignment, it's exactly the purpose. Until we truly find ourselves, sorry, this is the thing that God wanted. We do not wait for God or for a revelation agent that says, Now I know what my purpose is. I've been sitting here for 20 years. No, you don't sit for 20 years. From the moment that you know Jesus Christ as a personal savior, you are walking a path here. I want to know more. The more you want to know more, the more you do the things hanyane of what God wants you to do. Your discovery of your purpose is found when wena starts doing things and you realize, you know what, I don't know. This one thing, I am doing it very well without any effort. When just anytime you want this done, just call me. Because of this one, I just do it like no effort at all. That's where your purpose is. If we can just have a short prayer. Father, we pray and we pray for your word. That it can do your work over every ear. Therefore, I pray that upon the ear that understands your way, your word, I pray for the power Jesus Christ, to do and the revelation of yourselves, that a man of God can be perfected unto doing your great work that you have already ordained for my pillow. Jesus Christ, I pray, amen and amen. Shalom to you.
Thank you for watching Online Pulpit. Be encouraged to subscribe, click the bell, like, comment, and share. For the submissions of sermons, please email us on pulpit@created.com. Amen.